good rods. Just be careful of those rolls. Sit tall and look for them. You gotta read the water. Go with it. It's a hoot.
Obviously proud of his base camp, and rightfully so. We all came here to rough it on the river, not off the river.
How do you like that?
That's, I like it.
You like it better than standard?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, then there's one other. Come try it.
There's no wasting any time. Once the boats are fitted out just right, the BOBO is calling, just a stone's throw away.
You guys are all good paddlers. You know what the score is. If you're really comfortable, you're going to be out there. If you're not, you're probably going to either stick pretty close to Chris or I. When we get to the Royal Flush Gorge, we'll probably get things a little more structured because there's about five or six pretty good rapids in there where you could possibly have some problems. And at the very least, you'll want to know where to go, and we'll also be getting out and scouting one of them.
In no time at all, you can leave winter behind and slide into the endangered waters of the BOBO. Paddling in the valley of 100 waterfalls is the perfect warm-up for the infamous Royal Flush. Chris Spelius and Ken Kastorf have worked hard to make Expediciones Chile the smoothest, safest way to paddle three of Chile's finest rivers. Someone once said paddling through the Royal Flush is always a roll of the dice, and it's here at the One-Eyed Jack that the BOBO raises the stakes considerably. The One-Eyed Jack is an impressive sight. Littered with keeper holes and troublesome rocks, this rapid is definitely worth a scout.
Yeah, I've seen people in that hole. I've been in that hole myself. It's, you see that little back? It's not the best.
Looks pretty good, man.
Yeah, let's do it.
Down here in Chile, running rapids.
Paddling with Ken and Chris is like following a couple of friends down their local creek. But even so, the time soon comes when you have to climb in your boat and take what's dealt to you.
Thank you.
paddling out of the Royal Flush, we retreat to our base camp for some well-deserved creature comforts. The hot showers with a view of the BOBO are just one more example of Spee's attention to detail, and it's that attention to detail that makes Expediciones Chile unique. The camaraderie and healthy food create an atmosphere that's conducive to good paddling, always with the emphasis on safety.
And in general, too, throughout the rest of the day, if you see something that doesn't look good to you, remember, there's a good walk around it. You're going to be back down here again in 2 days. You don't have to push it the first day. So if something doesn't look good, just come and tell either Chris or I. We'll show you where you can walk. All of the rapids have a way around them.
Don't look too bad to me up to now. Tell you what, I'll tell you better when I get down it.
Did you say that in English?
That is English, not American, mate. I say they don't look too bad. There's a couple of possible routes down.
Yes, Patrick, way hard.
The problem is that once you get down here, there's a lot of push. You can go right. I mean, don't get stressed if you skip the right in the rock. Just come down and look back over the left. Decisions are made and most of the people go for the right-hand run. On the right, you're not dealing with the massive main flow of the river, but the line is complex and filled with potential hazards of its own, and definitely not easy.
One bladder zone, okay.
Yeah, and you can tolerate more.
He hasn't reached his limit yet.
When I peeled out,
what did that
I was committed, the fear was gone. And I, it was
is hard to describe.
When you're coming down that final turn, and you see that diagonal coming out the left wall, you see the right diagonal coming, and you're going into that that vortex. What went through your mind, man?
It's like chaos, total chaos, wave explosion. I just focused right in front of my bow into that vortex. I just wanted to stay straight.
You're sitting in that eddy, and you're going, maybe I'm going to go for the eddy, and maybe I'm going to go for the throat.
Yeah.
And you didn't make up the mind. You actually peeled out?
Until right before I peeled out.
And what was it? What was the determining factor? I mean, what makes a guy decide that he's going to go down the throat at lava?
I thought I could do it. Watching it run from up above helped a lot. I thought I could do it. And I thought again that it may be a long time before I'm down here again. And I didn't want to go back home without having tried it. I didn't want to go back home without having attempted that run.
History. Come on, guys, let's get out of here. We got a whole river to run.
Next, there's a series of rapids that would be a fine day's paddling anywhere else. But after running lava south, it's just a stroll back home.
Jerry, you caught some entertainment today, no doubt about it. I mean, that whole scene.
Where's the beer? We get to go through a river that loses some serious altitude. 30-foot waterfall. That's just a start. I love it.
After the Biobío, we go down to the exotic Rio Fui, a pristine river in the heart of Chile's Lake District. The Fui is famous for its champagne-like water quality and natural beauty. Paddling on the Fui is a completely different experience, where the numerous steep drops and waterfalls are interspersed with pools where the water is so clear you can see 25 feet to the bottom. Just looking at La Leona Falls from a kayaker's viewpoint is enough to scare the out of you. And most people decide right away that at this water level, the 30-foot drop is a bit more than they want to bite off. But then again, there are those intrepid few who for some reason need to push the issue and give serious consideration to running this waterfall.
Great. If you get too much speed, what'll end up happening is you come off of there and land too flat. Hand kicking.
Yeah.
Definitely don't want to do that.
No.
The big drop of La Leona is just the start of an intense finale to the upper Fui. Immediately, there's another serious falls feeding into a half mile of class 4-5 whitewater that culminates with an 18-foot plunge into a pool of blue champagne. Most dramatic whitewater discovery in recent years, and Expediciones Chile gives you the easiest, most rapid access to this magnificent river. With SPI's streamlined logistics, you can leave the United States and be on the new frontier of extreme boating in less than 24 hours. Flying into Chaiten from Puerto Montt, the scenery changes dramatically. Indeed, we are on the frontier of Chilean Patagonia, a land of mist-shrouded peaks and glaciers. The overnight transition from a North American winter to summer in Chile is delightful, and soon we're on our way into the mountains.
They just don't stop.
Hey,
is known as an expert run, but speed makes it possible for intermediate paddlers to come to Chile and be challenged on the Rio Azul and less intense sections of the Futaleufú. Spend a week honing your skills with Ken and Chris, and then hike in to see the gigantic rapids like Terminator, Throne Room, and the Zeta.
The thing that you have to really be conscious of is making your cuts into these eddies and not letting any of these curlers, and there's a few of them there, start surfing you out into the middle. It's not that difficult to do. It's just be really aware of where you're going and aware of your angles more than anything else.
And again, if someone blows it, we'll probably end up going down with them. So
yeah.
The show stops. So don't let your guard down.
Don't let your guard down. Some words to live by from Ken Kastorf as he and some other expert kayakers commit themselves to the strong currents of the Futaleufú. This is the crown jewel of Chilean rivers, and no sane person would be here if he or she didn't think they could handle it. Paddling the Futaleufú becomes a mind game and a matter of trust. Trust in ourselves to take what the foo has to dish out. Trust in Ken and Chris to pull our asses out of trouble if we were wrong.
I want you guys to be aware of the hazards, first of all, here, and then I'll show you how to get around. But, you know, you saw that big fold up at the top. You don't brace off that thing. That thing engulfs you. You know, if you're having visions of bracing on it and riding it to the middle, forget it.
Yeah, if you want to try to run this thing, I think I've got a route. It's really hard to hit, but if you do, you know, you don't even go over. It's really hard to hit. That shelf rock over there, can you see that shelf rock? It's undercut. So if you run this rapid, you gotta know that you stay in your boat.
A lot of people approach the Zeta for the first time knowing they don't need to run it. This rapid has that kind of reputation. The amount of energy flowing through this narrow slot is incredible, and it's true, there are serious consequences if you blow it. But after watching Spee and Chris Wilcox's relatively smooth runs, many of us who portaged privately think, well, maybe next time.
Chile and have your body and soul cleansed by the translucent waters of the Biobío, Rio Fui, and Futaleufú. It's possible thanks to the dedicated hard work of Chris Spelius and Expediciones Chile.